Efficiency is everything in the fleet operation business. Fleet operators care about the savings in fuel cost, the IoT capabilities, and also the impact on the environment and sustainability. That's why business like Blitz embraces Electrum and also EV transition. So I sat down with Xavier to understand how Blitz has built a high-performance fleet powered entirely by electric motorcycles and what makes their approach so effective. All right, Xavier, thanks for having me here, yeah?
Thanks, man.
So I'm glad we can do this little interview for people and the audiences to learn more about Blitz, right? And also the EV transition in Indonesia and Jakarta specifically. But of course, I know you guys have been operating many, many cities in Indonesia. So for the people who are, you know, unfamiliar with Blitz, could you tell us a little bit about Blitz history and what do you guys do?
For sure. So we are the leading and largest EV enabler in the nation today. We operate nationwide in every single tier one city in Indonesia. I think it's roughly about 35 cities today. And we work for roughly 60 enterprise clients. So these are your big names, whether it's an e-commerce giant, a coffee giant, or a pizza giant. We work with pretty much most of the big names. And our goal is pretty much simple. Our goal is to enable electric vehicle adoption in a way that is sustainable, not only for these companies, but also for the end user, which is the gig drivers. So in doing that, we have now been operating for 3+ years and enabled more than 2,000 drivers to have electric vehicle financing, electric vehicle related jobs as a part of our platform. Put it simply, the service that we offer to our customers, which are our clients, is instant and on-demand delivery.
Great. And tell us about yourself, like what led you to this idea?
Before this, by trade, I'm a mechanical engineer. I used to work for this company called Hyperloop in the US for some time. And it was there that I had the idea I wanted to do something in the EV space. And this was sparked after many interviews with drivers that I would have on the road during COVID.
Yeah.
They would tell me stories about how they're unable to actually afford the gasoline that they use to deliver the McDonald's that I've ordered.
Yeah.
That's where the EV financing and the EV ecosystem came into play. So we're solving problem number one, which is logistics. And then out of that, we're able to solve problem number two, which is better income for drivers, more equality, and better livelihoods for these customers.
Actually, in the beginning, you even made your bikes yourself, right? So what led you to choose Electrum as one of your partners?
So in business, it's always nice to have work with folks that have similar mindsets to you. But on a more objective level, the vehicles were, for our use case, they were strong, they were robust, meaning we can actually put a lot of cargo in the back. The vehicles are tech enabled, which allows us to get data, which is critically important. And at the same time, they're built with care. And this care is shown not only within the build quality, but also in the after sales.
Yeah.
And so all of these three components are necessary for us to work with any OEM vendor. There are so many OEM vendors to choose from these days. So we've been very limiting in who we work with because we want to make sure that our end customer's experience is good.
Yeah.
And in order for us to make sure that happens, every single component of our supply chain has to be perfect. And so kudos to you guys for building a great product.
Great, thanks. So I think maybe let's unpack some of these benefits.
Sure.
One by one. So first of all, what's the EV and especially electric's impact on your operational efficiency and cost savings?
Okay.
For your company and as well as for the drivers.
We have built a proprietary tech stack, which is today actually co-created with NVIDIA. And this tech stack and the, yeah, exactly. And this tech stack and the machine learning and the AI that is powering it, it is designed to do one thing, and that is take a lot of deliveries and squeeze that into very few number of drivers, which means every driver will actually earn far more on a per driver basis. If they're earning far more, they're able to then finance that vehicle effectively, right? So there's no income inequality problem. In order for this tech stack to then do this, it needs access to certain variables. One component of this is VMS and BMS data. So these are data points that we're able to get from your vehicles mm-hmm. and accordingly put that into our tech stack and allow that to process it as one of the variables that it's using to make decisions. So the better the data collection is from the vehicle standpoint, the far more accurate our tech stack will then be able to interpret that data as such. And so if we were to use a cheaply made product or something that doesn't have as robust of a data extracting capabilities, that'll affect the tech stack because your output is only as good as the input. We've seen drivers' efficiencies be bumped up to 25% to 30% compared to traditional gig working drivers, which means that a driver today working for Blitz is not only delivering 30% better, but earning 30% better. The better that tool is, the better the output is for drivers.
Yeah, exactly. And I think the benefit is also a function of scale. That actually translated into your output efficiency, right? Also, that output is also going to translate into lower cost of delivery cost per parcel, right? So as we use technology to improve efficiency overall, eventually everybody wins. Right. So the next question is, since you started this basically EV startup, what kind of environmental impact have you made?
So we have reduced more than 18 million, or rather prevented more than 18 million kilograms of CO2 emissions. And we've done close to now 12 million electric and green deliveries since we started, right? I think that's the single biggest impact we've had, because when you think about transportation as a whole, in consumer segments, B2C, when you're commuting from home to office, the emissions are not that much. You're just going in one route back and forth every single day.
Yeah.
Whereas in logistics and supply chain, you're using routes every single hour, and it's a new route every single time, and it's essentially 24/7 operations, which means you have a greater impact within this segment of the transportation industry than you would in just a commuting segment. Mm-hmm. So for that reason, our numbers kind of also show the same.
Great. So I think last question is about your vision about EV conversion and EV fleets in the business of fleet management. But you are trying to build something like very scalable fleet management based on technology. So where do you see the fleet business going, and how can EV be a big contributing part of this journey?
If you change from gasoline to electric, the total ownership cost (TOC) is less. So yes, you're going to make more margins, but the efficiencies will come from the fact that these are connected vehicles. Today, that's just not possible, because in order for a gasoline fleet to become smart, you have to expend into hardware, you have to install IoTs, then you have to buy a SaaS platform, a software as a service platform that can then decode that, and then have to pay a third party. So it is a bit of there are many bottlenecks, and it's not as easy to become efficient as a fleet owner today than it will be in the future. And EVs are definitely the way to leave that, because out of the factory, these things are connected and become connected. So I think that's where I see the industry going in the future.
So I guess to give a quick summary, right? I think Xavier is someone who understands technology, right? And sometimes it takes a technologist's mind to really truly appreciate a new and nascent technology, and then be able to utilize whatever the technology offers to really create value. Right, so I think in summary, I think there are three things Xavier really cared about. One is efficiency improvement and cost saving by using technology. I think the secondly is, of course, how to best use IoT to optimize the system to create the ultimate outcome. And lastly is the environmental impact, right, that we do. And I think from this conversation, I hope you understand more about the technical nuances of this whole ecosystem, right? And then I hope that you can appreciate that how EV, right, enabled, being IoT enabled can really help our partner to make certain business model possible and also improving their current business model. All right, thank you very much.
Likewise, man. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Yeah.